Welcome to Business Industrial Network Training. This module will cover variable frequency drive essentials. It is designed to provide product knowledge for all levels from beginner to expert. At the conclusion of this module, you can register to receive your certificate of completion. Be sure to take advantage of obtaining this documentation. It will serve as proof that you completed the course. Now let's get started. PID control is a very popular application for industrial processes. The letters stand for proportional, integral, and derivative, the three calculations that comprise what is sometimes called a loop. It incorporates an algorithm or formula that makes calculations of the process and provides feedback to the controller that allows the desired output. An entire session could be developed to cover this topic in detail. A simple explanation, however, might be to examine a cruise control system on an automobile. A driver sets a desired speed, and the controller takes into account varying conditions such as wind, road conditions, and inclines. As the controller senses the varying conditions, calculations are being made to ensure that the desired speed is maintained. Here is the block diagram representing the process. Note that each element has its own formula. It looks complicated, but the operator merely needs to input a few values, and the controller then takes over the process. We will examine this concept in more detail later in this module. No doubt the single biggest market for VFDs are into the HVAC industry. You will hear this acronym a lot when discussing drives. It stands for heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. Many reports cite that 15% of the world's energy consumption is from motors used in HVAC application. That's right, behind the walls and ceilings of every commercial and industrial building are a multitude of motors that provide heating and ventilation for areas inside the building. These are fans, air handlers, air conditioning units, and exhaust systems. During low occupancy, building managers can adjust the speed motors are running, thereby saving money on electric consumption by as much as 30%. We will see how this is accomplished a little later on in our discussion. Variable frequency drives are set up by using a keypad on the drive. This keypad is also used to run, monitor, and program the drive. Some drives, when first powered up, automatically go into the run mode. They can be easily changed to the monitor mode by toggling the membrane mode switch and again to program by once again pressing the mode switch. It is important to note that the symbols used for programming may vary between manufacturers. In this instance, the Schneider Altavar 212 uses the symbol THR for inputting the thermal overload value. Most drives can be set up very easily for routine applications by inputting information from the motor nameplate, namely full load current, motor nominal voltage, and desired overload current level, which in most cases may be the same as the full load current of the motor. Many manufacturers offer an alternative LCD keypad with English text that spells out the function rather than provide a symbol. In most cases, these can be interchanged with the standard supplied keypad or as a remote mounting kit. Coming up, we'll talk about the other VFD functions available from most drive manufacturers. In our definition, we mentioned that VFDs help vary the speed of an AC motor. Well then, why not just let the motor run at full speed, then use a brake to get the desired speed? This practice would be equivalent to driving a car with the accelerator pressed to the floor while applying a brake with your left foot to meet the desired speed limit. Now that sounds a little bit far-fetched, but using a variable frequency drive allows for energy efficiency by only utilizing the exact amount of power to operate at a speed the load requires. In addition, the amount of mechanical stress in equipment such as belts, shivs, bearings are minimized. Lastly, some applications, as we will see, such as conveyors, fans, are ideal for a smooth operation and changes in speeds offered by a VFD. A typical sewage treatment plant has many stations utilizing these equipment applications. This equipment will run at optimized electric power while eliminating mechanical stress and saving money on costly maintenance. A popular application for pumps and compressors is a duplex design. In pump applications, an alternator is used with either a pressure transducer or a float switch. In these applications, a pump starts when the pressure is required. As the initial pump comes up to full speed, if more pressure is required, a second pump starts. Once the system is satisfied, drive manufacturers have the ability to accept feedback signals to set up a PID loop internal to their drives. Loop refers to the cycle of control. Open loop basically means that there is no feedback going directly to the drive. A closed loop system, however, provides more accurate control of the drive. In closed loop applications, PID settings and a speed reference are programmed. If the actual speed varies from the set point, it is referred to as an off the set point, or offset for short. Let's recap what happened. The marketplace is jam-packed with manufacturers, large and small, offering variable frequency drives. This slide will feature some of them. Eaton Electrical has a wide variety of drives from different applications. One popular segment of the line is their SPX 9000 general purpose and SPX 9000 high performance models. Much of this offering are Vacon drives rebranded for Eaton. Franklin Electric out of Portland, Oregon supplies their P series for tight or high performance and PowerFlex 755 for their harmonic mitigating drives. Siemens labels their drives MicroMaster, Simatics, and SciMotion. They cover a wide variety of applications, including HVAC. Some manufacturers offer low-end VFDs as part of their line. These are labeled as micro and mini. They are also sold in board-level designs. Micro is the smallest with the least amount of features. Mini is the next step up, offering a few more features such as a display readout. Popular among OEMs are board-level versions of these drives. OEMs mounted in their equipment. Let's take some time to go over the standards that apply to variable frequency drives. NEMA, the National Electrical Manufacturers Association, has a standard titled NEMA ICS 61800-2-2005. This applies to general purpose adjustable frequency drives that include power conversion, control equipment, and an AC motor or motors. This also applies to systems connected to line voltages up to 1 kV AC, 50 or 60 Hz, and load side frequency up to 600 Hz. The European Commission has issued electromagnetic capability EMC 61800-3 Adjustable Speed Electrical Power Drive Systems Part 3 EMC requirements and specific test methods. The CE mark has become. Now, why do engineers specify bypass on drives? The primary reason is to keep machines, especially those of critical nature, running. It is an outcome from the 1970s when VFDs were in the early stages of development. There were many failures with the circuit boards and SCRs. Customers were anxious to obtain energy savings, but the high failure rates caused manufacturers to offer bypass packages as a backup. Bypass was considered a low-cost method to keep the motor running in case of a VFD going down. Today's VFD failure rates are approximately 0.25%. In many cases, the bypass components fail at a higher rate than the VFDs. Therefore, the cost appropriated for bypass components in some cases are better suited channeling toward a spare drive. This is especially important if the spare can serve as a backup for several drives inside a plant. Redundant VFDs are a logical choice for critical applications. As seen here, they work on the principle that if one VFD fails, full control and protection are maintained by a second VFD that automatically takes over. Redundant VFDs have been around for years, but only recently has this concept become cost effective. As the VFD variable frequency drives, because of their compact size, can be retrofitted into existing motor control centers. Replacing the standard starter or multi-speed starter can be easily accomplished. This represents a considerable energy savings opportunity for customers. However, caution needs to be exercised. Since VFDs generate considerable more heat than a conventional motor starter, proper ventilation needs to be addressed. Also, let's go through the selection factors that apply to variable frequency drives. You need to know the horsepower, voltage, and if the voltage is single phase or three phase. Next, you need to know whether it's constant torque or variable torque. Next, you will need to know if a disconnect is required, and if a disconnect is required, if it is a breaker or a switch, and the current rating or fuse clip rating that applies. Next, you need to find out if an output contactor is required, if an input line reactor is required, or a load reactor, if dynamic braking is required, and then if bypass is required, is a two contactor or three contactor required? What are the pilot lights and switches required for the bypass operation? Is redundancy required using two drives? Then you need to know the NEMA or IP rating of the enclosure. And lastly, if any special boards are needed for interfacing with a network system or with an encoder.